That video gonna be about old mad dog Russo, but I gotta give it to him for standing his ground. I gotta give it to him for standing his ground. I gotta give it to him for standing his ground. He wasn't buying the sideshow of LeBron James and Bronny. And I've been said it. It's not fashionable to tell the truth about the antics of LeBron James and the fact that Bronny James had no business being on the court with what was happening. And apparently, I think LeBron sent his camp, his goons over to try to shake up the ESPN camp to get Russo to retract. Now, I know before Laker fans come bombard me, yeah, I know they're 2-0. They came back with a win last night. You know, they had all them free throws last night. Anthony Davis is the reason why you're where you are. Because Reeves came up big last night. But let me tell you something. If AD don't play like he's trying to channel Shaquille O'Neal, Tim Duncan, Olajuwon, etc., they're not a threat. He got to average like 30-plus every night. He cannot have a game where he's 20 or less. They're not that good. But anyway, that's not about that. This is about the fact that you can't be a journalist anymore. You can't be a sports journalist no more. You can't criticize or critique the obvious. You know, it's kind of like when people get mad when you tell the truth. They don't really, you know, part of being grown and having a voice is being able to state facts. So when you tell the truth about what's going on, you're not making it up. No one is trying to wish Bronny James not to reach his full potential. But the Lakers are sending him to the G League. They set up the road trip. Well, duh. He should have never even been playing aside from being a spectator. He had no business being on the court. This whole photo op, is this kind of like the Adam Morrison photo op when the Lakers won those back-to-back chips when he came to with Kobe and Paul Gasol and all them back in 09-2010, he was able to get into the photo because Phil Jackson said, come in and get in the photo. Is this what this is about? Because if it's about a photo op, you could have done it for a lot less. You could have just waited till after the game. You know, it's been a joke. Mad Dog Russo, I don't always agree with certain things he says, and there's certain things I kind of like look at him side-eye, but when he's on, he's on. But this is the thing. He is a journalist. He is credible. He'd been around before there was a LeBron James was a thought. And he credibility, and when you're a broadcast analyst, you're supposed to tell what you see, what you feel. That's what people get paid to. Now, in this lay in time, they have to do what I call makeshift TV. They have to do like be bought and paid. They have to do corporate branding. They have to do stuff where they have to talk about things that aren't really there. You know how like why I'm disappointed with Kenny the Jet Smith, because that lunacy of saying LeBron's a top two player and supporting Bronny, looking at him sideways, cross-eyed and crazy. But I understand Clutch Sports probably got to him. He probably got a deal coming once TNT is no longer. They got a plans for him. Don't be get bought and paid off. If you see something, tell it like it is. Take the repercussions, live with it. I told you before and I said again, Bronny sucked. Sorry, 4-point average in college with USC does not translate to you being a first. I saw Kenny Jet Smith talking about, well, that means that you could be like a late guard or you might potential and you McDonald's off. That don't mean nothing. That's not NBA career. This is grown men business. Somebody was kind enough to link me up to a Lakers Spurs game, which I hadn't seen in ages, from 83 game five with the Spurs won before the Lakers were going to get smashed by the Sixers. And that great Sixers run, Magic and Bob McDowell out there on that run. Someone sent that link up to take me back down deja vu. When you had to run and play during the Showtime era, which I used to watch all the time, just hadn't watched that game in a long time. But the point of the matter was this. You had grown men competing at a high level. Not this made-for-TV mess that they be trying to throw at you where they trying to say, well, everybody, it's like the Oprah Winfrey syndrome. You get a shot, I get a shot, you get a shot. No, if you're not ready, you're not ready. Okay? You can tell when someone is not just green, but they just Dr. Seuss level. The hat, the eyes is bugged out, and it ain't happening. It wasn't happening for Bronny. And Russo was one of the few to tell the facts. Charles Barkley did too. Magic did initially before he played pity pat and went back on him. But that's at Hollywood. Ha 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 ha. Anyway, props to Mad Dog Russo for stating the facts. If it means that they take him off the air, more people will support Mad Dog even more. There will be a day when LeBron James has no voice to dictate and command and sway all this stuff. And I'll be so glad. I will be so glad. Because it's hard to watch basketball when that man is part of it, if you must know. Because he didn't wreck the NBA as I know it. All his antics and theatrics and everything about him, you know, he can't go a day without people talking. People can call Michael Jordan a narcissist and say over the top and he talks in the third person, all that. But I have not seen the day when Michael Jordan retired or Michael Jordan was away, even in the era of social media or whatever he was doing, he doesn't make himself front and center. But this jive turkey can't keep a camera. Can't, everything got to revolve around him and he want everything to be all proper and all said and all. I'm like, that is just, but that's why Jenny Buss tolerates you. Because it's the 24-hour machine that's always at work. But when you're not there no more and nobody care, maybe you can go have your own version of your Diddy parties. But leave the basketball to the eyes of seeing things as they are. Not for what the hyperbole that you're trying to make them out to be. Because that kid had no business playing on the court. That was photo op. Y'all could have saved that for old school Olin Mills. If you know about Olin Mills, you know what I'm talking about. Or when you're doing the family portrait thing at the local studio. If you want to take it back old school. Or go to a photo booth and y'all can say cheese together. But not on no grown folks, grown man's basketball time. Please like, subscribe, welcome thoughts, comments. And I do respond. Thank you. Wash your hands. Keep your mind clear. Watch out for another. Share it if you like. Hit that membership. Stay blessed. Stay true. Stay real. Stay woke. Stay free. I'm out one time. Peace.